out, everyone. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to those of you who are here in the sanctuary. Let's say hallelujah to the Lord. For those of you that are joining us via Zoom or Facebook, we say hallelujah to the Lord. Praise his holy name. We are so blessed to have this privilege to worship one more time and to have one more season, one more holy season that we culminate in Resurrection Sunday, where we acknowledge the fact that our Lord and Savior has risen from the dead. And because he lives, we have life. So we are here this morning to worship and to give praise to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for one more opportunity. We are so grateful this morning. We are so thankful to you for what you've done. Thank you, Lord. Thank you this morning. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. You are worthy, O God. You are worthy, O God. We proclaim this morning that you are worthy, O God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We invite you to stand at this time for the reading of the scripture. We're going to ask Sister Marcia Joseph if she would come forward. After the reading of the scripture, we will have Deacon Glenn Bassett to come forward with our morning prayer. It is in that order that we shall proceed.
Praise God, praise God, praise God. Good morning, Unity. Good morning. Today's scripture comes from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 28, the last chapter, verses 16 through 20. Then the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had told them to go. When they saw him, they worshiped him, but some doubted. Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded of you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age." May God continue to bless us through his word.
Written in the scriptures, while Jesus was tarrying with the disciples, one of the disciples asked him, "Lord, teach us how to pray." And he responded, he said, "When you pray, say, 'Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen." Father, we come before you this morning in a special way. We acknowledge today, Lord, as the Lord's Day. We know that some thousand years ago that your son died for us on the cross. Brutally treated, he whipped them all night long and hung them on the cross until he died a fleshly death. But he said that he would rise on the third day. Well, today is the third day. We thank you, Lord, for sending your son for us. You loved this world so, you loved us so till you sent your only begotten son down here to die for us. So that we that believe would not perish but have everlasting life. Everlasting life. Everlasting life. Victory is in our relationship with you. We believeth in you, Lord, and you give us everlasting life. It doesn't matter what goes on around us. We believe in you, Lord God, and we are promised everlasting life. Love one another as we love ourselves and treat everybody right. Set a walk before the world so they know in which direction to go, and they follow us and they see that we got our hands in your hands, and they may throw up their hands and say, what must I do to be saved? We thank you, Lord, for that love for us. The songwriter wrote a song, said that he agreed to it. He agreed to it, to go to the cross for me. He could have came down if he wanted to. But his love and your love for us, he stayed on the cross to die for us. We thank you, Lord God, for being in our lives. We pray, Lord, that you would bless everyone that's here, sitting in their tent doors, waiting to hear the word this morning, Lord. We don't know who or where, but everyone is looking for something, Lord, and we pray for your blessings to come down this morning. We know that you're already here because you said, where two or three to gather together in your midst, to gather together in your name, that you would be in the midst. And we can feel your movement through this place already, Lord, and we thank you for being with us, Lord. Bless the waiting congregation, Lord, that's here, and those who are in virtual land waiting and watching, Lord, and all of those who may not be able to come but want to be, and those that are in the hospitals and the nursing homes, Lord, we pray blessings on them as well, Lord God. Bless our pastor, Lord, as he stands before us to deliver thy word, Lord. And we pray, Lord, that when we leave this place, that we would leave with a blessing, Lord, filled to capacity so that we may be able to go out into the world and shine our lights that much brighter so others may see your glory. Then, Lord, when all our work here is done, we pray that you would have a place for us somewhere up on high where we may sit by your feet and be blessed. All these blessings we ask in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! He hath risen from the dead because he is Lord. Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. I don't know about you, but I'm excited about the day. Hallelujah! Blessed be the name of the Lord of our salvation, who is our rock of all ages. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! If you love him today, come on and put your hands together and give God some praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. The hymn of the church, the old rugged cross. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. Hallelujah. If you all would rest to your feet and let's sing the hymn together. On a hill.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And my love, that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain.
So I cherish.
So I cherish the old rugged cross.
Till my trophies.
Till my trophies.
I will cling,
I will cling to the old rugged cross
and exchange it.
And exchange it someday for a crown.
Oh,
that old rugged cross, so despised by the world, has a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it to dark Calvary. So I
God. Feels good in here, don't it? So glad to see some worshipers in here with me. I'm not alone. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, sir. And we're moving on. All right. This is a worship song. We're still celebrating. We're still celebrating. Come on, let's stand to your feet and put your hands together. It's a call and response song. So all you have to do is repeat after me. Glory, glory, glory to our King.
Glory, glory, glory to our King.
To the Lamb who was slain for my being.
To the Lamb who was slain for my being.
Glory, glory, glory to our King.
Glory, glory, glory to our King.
To the Lamb who was slain for my being. Glory to our King.
Glory to our King.
I'll say it one more time. Glory, glory, glory to our King.
Glory, glory, glory to our King.
To the Lamb who was slain for our being.
To the Lamb who was slain for my being.
Glory, glory, glory to our King.
Glory, glory, glory to our King.
To the Lamb who was slain for our being.
To the Lamb who was slain for our being.
We cry glory. Holy, holy is our King.
Holy, holy, holy is our King.
To the Lamb who was slain for my being.
To the Lamb who was slain for our being.
Holy, holy, holy is our King.
Holy, holy, holy is our King.
To the Lamb who was slain for our being. Cry
glory to our King.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We cry
glory to our King.
Sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lord, you're worthy.
Lord, you're worthy.
We cry glory. Sing a new song to our King.
Sing a new song to our King.
To the Lamb who was slain for my being.
To the Lamb who was slain for our being.
Sing a new song to our King.
Sing a new song to our King.
To the Lamb who was slain for our being.
To the Lamb.
We cry
glory to our King.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We cry glory
to our King.
Sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lord, you're worthy. Lord, you're worthy.
You're so worthy.
You're so worthy.
You're so worthy.
You're so worthy. You're so worthy. You're so righteous. You're so righteous. You're so righteous. You're so righteous. You're so holy. You're so holy. You're so holy. You're so holy. Lord, you're awesome. Lord, you're awesome. You're so awesome. You're so awesome. Lord, you're mighty. 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 You're so mighty. You're so mighty. You're so mighty. Lord, you're worthy. Lord, you're worthy. Lord, you're worthy. Lord, you're worthy. You're so holy. You're so holy. You're so holy. You're so holy. Sing hallelujah.
This Resurrection Sunday, he rose up. Let's rise up. Let's rise up and give the, you need to fix this mic. Let's rise up and give the Lord praise. Let's rise up and say glory, hallelujah. Let's rise up and thank the Lord for allowing us to see another Resurrection Sunday. Let's rise up and give God the glory. Is he worthy? Is he worthy? Come on, y'all. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank God. You may be seated. We thank God for allowing us to come into his house one more time. Amen. It is good to see you. We thank God. This is our second service of the day. So we've been praising the Lord since early this morning, giving God all the praise and honor that the Lord is due. And God is truly due the honor and the praise and the glory. So we thank God for how God is moving in the life of his churches all around the nation, all around the world, really. God is moving, and the Spirit of God is moving, and the resurrection is being celebrated. So we don't want to half step when it comes to praising God this morning. Amen? We want to give God the full. If it had not been for the resurrection, we wouldn't even be here. We wouldn't be saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Spirit, glorifying the Lord. We wouldn't even woke up this morning. This morning we preached on waking up to good news. We woke up to good news this morning that the Savior had risen, had gone a couple of days with bad news. You ever been there? You go a couple of days with bad news, and then all of a sudden out of nowhere God rises up and you got good news that come. So it's a glory unto God that we come in here this morning and say thank you, Lord God, for all that you have done in our lives. And we're going to continue the celebration throughout the day. We thank God for all those who participated. Really, during this whole Lent season, it has been a glory to God how we were able to meet and fellowship and Bible study and prayer 6 a.m. in the morning. Then we went into 6 p.m. We had the all-day fasting and praying. We started really the whole month, but we'll continue after this, fasting and praying. Then at 6 p.m., we had our meditation on the Word. And then 7:30 p.m. Bible study. So we should feel holier than we did last year with all of that. with all of that, you should really feel like God is moving and you've seen and heard something from the Lord as a result of all of that connecting with God. And that's what we were trying to do, connect with the Lord. And we'll continue that every Wednesday. Regardless of Lent season, we do it at the beginning of Lent season, but we want to continue because we want to continue to build our relationship with God. And so we will continue to have 6 a.m. prayer and then fasting and praying to 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. and then meditation in the Word. We get on Zoom and we listen to Scripture. And then at 7:30, we're back in Bible study. So we want to continue that really throughout the whole year if we can, because we have some work to do in the life of the church. As we go forward, we'll be working on plans for our next big celebration will be our church anniversary, 91 years as a church institution, 91 years celebrate, 92 years. I don't want to leave off another year. 92 years celebrating and having Resurrection Sundays for 92 years in the life of the church. And we'll be celebrating that on the third Sunday in May. And ask that you all join us for that as well. So we're ready to praise the Lord from then all the way up until now. Now all the way up until then and beyond, because of what the Lord has done and allowed us to come into his house. And we thank God for those who prepared breakfast this morning. God bless you. I did a wonderful job in preparing breakfast. You know, and then 9 a.m. we still had our Sunday school. So we've been rolling with the Lord all day. And then after service, for those who can, and we had you dressed in your finest today, as we do as black folks when we come to church on a Easter Sunday. And we will be taking pictures right after service. We want to take a congregational photo first, so everybody just line up immediately after service, if you will and you want to take a congregational photo. And then for those individuals who want to take one, we'll take it right here in the sanctuary because the light is better. So you can take your family photos right here in the sanctuary right after service. But we want to come together immediately following the service for those who will, because we want to get people to where they have to go, family and friends and anything else that may have to take place. So we just glorify the Lord. I'm waiting for my signal because we got a big surprise. So I'm thinking that our drama ministry is ready. Amen. Our drama ministry is ready. Amen. I'm thinking they are, because we're in for a real treat on this Resurrection Sunday. And I want to get them started as soon as possible so that we can, yes. You can't tell. They rose. Somebody got to rise up. Amen. And get them ready. Let me know where they are with that. But how many of you feel good this morning? Amen. If they take too much longer, I'm going to call on somebody for a resurrection testimony, how good God has been in your life and what the Lord has done. Because I know there are many testimonies in the house of the Lord this morning, and we could only take one, but one really good one. So if you think you have a testimony about what the Lord has done in your life, why don't you stand up right now? Now, everybody should have stood up right there. I'm not saying I'm going to call on all of you, but I'm saying that if anybody has a testimony that they know that God has been good in your life, just rise up right now. Just rise up. Rise up. If you know that you have a testimony, and now if you know that you have a testimony that you want to share, the first person that steps into the aisle will be able to tell it. He's first. He stepped out. I'm sorry. He stepped out way before. Amen. How you doing, brother? It's on. Yeah, it's on. Just speak into it.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
I couldn't come this morning and I said, Jesus is Jesus is Jesus is Jesus is, because he knew me. So I want to sing a little song, and you can help me sing it along. I'm not on an ego trip. I am nothing on my own. I make mistakes and often sleep. Just come and fly. and never shine. So unworthy of such mercy, yet when he was on the cross, I was on his mind.
Yes, yes, yes.
A look of love was on his face, the thorn on his head. The blood was on his scarlet robe, and stood it crimson red. Though his eyes were on the crown the day, he looked ahead in time. Yet when he was on the cross, I was on his mind. He knew me, yet he loved me. He was brought and died and always shine. So unworthy,
yes, yes, yes,
of such mercy, yet when he was on that rugged cross, you and I was on his mind.
Amen, amen. That's a testimony right there. We thank God for that. Has God been good to anybody in here? Has God been good to anybody? Amen. Well, let's praise the Lord and let's use our hands in order to give God the glory and give God the praise. And at this time, we want to thank God for how God has blessed us to come thus far and how God allowed us to come into his house one more time. Sometimes we take it for granted that we're in the house of the Lord, but this is no time to take it for granted. This is a time to really set aside everything that we have on our minds in order to praise God and give God the glory. So at this time, as they're getting ready, the choir's getting ready, we're going to uplift our offering. Has God been good to anybody? Let's not stop worshiping now. Uplift our offering at this time. And then we're going to ask those who will to come down and bring the tithes and the offering into the storehouse. And we just thank you for your giving over time and over these last couple of months in this new year. And we want you to continue to do so. Continue to give and give from the bottoms of your heart. Give as the Lord has prospered you, as the word of God said. And thank God for being able to give. Some people are not able to give. But when you're able to give, you ought to thank the Lord for being able to give. Let us pray. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord God, for just allowing us to be able to give back to you that which belongs to you. We thank you, Lord God, for rising us up this morning in order to come into your house to praise your holy name, to have the hands that you gave us to clap and the mouth that you gave us to sing and the feet that you gave us to dance. Oh, what a wonderful and awesome God we serve. So, Lord God, right now we're asking that we would be true to your word and bring the tithes and offering into the storehouse. Oh, you blessed us so, Lord God. And we know that you love a cheerful giver. So help our hearts, Lord God, and our minds to be in place so that we may be able to give back to you that which belongs to you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Let the church say amen, amen, and amen again. Okay, those who are part of tithing the community, tithing the offering, you could just come out, get up, just come down the middle aisle from the back. On down, come down the middle aisle. You could all come down the middle aisle. Start from the back. Why don't we stand so that people don't have to get over us? Just stand up. We could just stand so that people can get through. Amen. Just let them come through. Amen. There's also online giving, Givelify, as well as Zelle. Givelify and Zelle, you are able to give. Amen. Why don't we all stand? Amen. Amen. You look great out there. Amen. God bless you all. Heavenly Father, we thank you again for just allowing us to come into your house and give back to you that which belongs to you. We're asking, Lord God, that you would bless it so that it may be used for building your kingdom. We thank you, Lord God, for all those who had to give and gave truly from the heart and from the context of the word of God. Bring the tithes and the offering into the storehouse. Bless those who did not have to give so that the next time around they may be able to give to your building of your kingdom. We thank you, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray. Let the church say amen, amen, and amen. You may be seated. Let's give a big hand to our drama ministry as they come forward. Amen. Let's praise God for the drama ministry.
The stone is rolled away.
Someone has taken our Lord.
Oh. And the tomb is empty. Someone has stolen our Lord. Oh my God. Sir, tell me. have taken him, so I can go to him. Someone has taken him. Oh, Lord. Just tell me. Just tell me where you have taken him, so I can go to him. Take him. Our Lord, someone help. Someone help me. I need to find him. I just need to find him. I just need to know. Just tell me so I can go to him. Just tell me. Someone has taken my Lord. Just tell me. I will go. Just tell me where you have taken him. I do not know. I don't know. Someone.
Woman. Why are you crying? And who are you looking?
Someone have taken my Lord. I do not know where they have taken him.
Mary.
Rabbi.
Do not hold on to me. But instead, go and tell my brothers that I am ascending to the heavens. And tell them that my God is their God.
Jesus. 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 He has risen. He lived. Oh, I have to go tell them. Jesus is there. Hallelujah.
To tremble, tremble, because I was there when they crucified my Lord. He is dead. Jesus is gone.
What do we do? What do we do?
Brothers. Brothers. Yeah,
Jesus is dead.
What do we do?
Jesus is dead.
It's Mary.
Mary.
I saw him.
What is she doing?
I saw him.
Who'd you see, Mary?
I saw him.
Who?
I saw Jesus.
You saw Jesus.
He has risen.
Jesus.
I saw him.
You got it.
I saw him. I saw him.
Mary, be Mary. Real.
No. You must be out your mind. He gone.
I saw him. I saw him. I saw Jesus. As I was going to the tomb, I saw a man.
And the man said, why do you visit the living amongst the dead? Jesus is not there. As I went, I saw the stone rolled away. The tomb was empty. I asked everybody, just help me. Tell me so I can go get him. And I heard him say, Mary. I went to reach to touch him. He said, touch me not, for I have not ascended to my Father. But go and tell my brothers that I'm ascended to my Father, your Father, my God, and your God. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus has risen. He has risen.
Woman's fantasy.
I don't. He's risen. Jesus, our Lord and Savior, has risen. John, you believe me?
Mary.
Woman's fantasies, you said? Fantasies. Was his death a fantasy? Was his death a fantasy? I saw our Lord and Savior. I saw him. Why wouldn't our Lord and Savior appear to me? I was there. I was there when he carried that cross. I was there when they beat him. I was there. And the very cross that he carried, they stretched him. Oh, and they put nails in his hands. And they put his foot and they pierced him in his side. I saw him. Our Lord and Savior. He lived. He lives. But he told me to tell you. And I have done so. Because our Lord and Savior, he lives. He lives. He lives.
Because he said so. He said so. Thank you, Jesus.
But Peter,
what?
You denied him. Not once, not twice, but three times.
I know. I denied my Lord. I denied him three times. Glory, Lord, forgive me. I was a coward. I was scared. I ran. I walked with Jesus on the water. I talked with him. I ate with him. But when he needed me most, I ran. But I wasn't the only one. All of you ran. Like cowards, we ran. We ran. But brothers, today's a day of jubilation. Mary gave us the good news. Philip, you believe? Thomas, I know you believe. What do you mean you don't believe, Thomas? You believe.
I don't believe it.
Thomas. Come back, Thomas. Come back, Thomas. Oh, Lord Jesus. Brothers. Brothers. The time now is not for pointing fingers. The time for us to come together. Our Savior is risen. He is risen. He is risen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Wait a minute. Lord.
Oh.
Lord. Is that you? Jesus.
Oh, Lord, thank you. Thank you, Lord.
Peace be unto you.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Now receive the Holy Spirit.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
As the Father has sent me,
yes.
I am now sending you.
Yes, Lord.
If you forgive one sin,
yes,
their sins are forgiven.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
If you do not forgive them, they are not forgiven.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Brothers, our Savior, we see him. We have joy. We have joy. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Everybody has breath. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thomas. Thomas. We saw the Lord. He was here, Thomas. He was here. No, Thomas. No, Thomas.
I still don't believe him. I still don't believe him.
Oh, Thomas.
I need to see his hands, where those nails were, so I can put my finger on him. I didn't. I don't. You all saw him, but I have not seen him. I have not seen him. I want to touch his side. I'm a doubting. I don't believe he has rose from the ground. I don't believe. I don't believe. No, no. I have not seen him. Where is he?
Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Now place your hand in my side.
Master, it is you.
You must stop doubting and believe, Thomas.
Yes, Lord, you live.
Is he worthy? Is he worthy?
Yeah.
All
yeah.
right, come on.
Keep the worship going. Keep it 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 going. Come on, choir. You're supposed to be up by now. Come on. Keep it going. Keep it going. Stay there in your uniform. Come on. Worship. Worship him. Worship him. Come on, choir. Amen. Let us stand. Let us stand. That should have been a standing song. He reigns forever. Yes. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a big hand. That's all right. You ain't going to find a better celebration of Jesus Christ in the church than Unity Baptist Tabernacle. We had to go all out for unity this morning. Amen. That shows a real celebration, a real adoration of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So we just thank God for the drama ministry. We thank God for the choir. Thank God who read the scripture. We thank God for the music ministry. Everybody is just in sync in order to give God the glory. So this is how we're supposed to do it. Anybody's asking why they got to do all of that, because say, you don't know what the Lord has done for me. Say, some people say it don't take all of that, but you don't know what it took for the Lord to get me from where I am and from what I was doing. So you got to come in here and give God the glory and give God all the praise as much as you can, for as long as you can, because you don't know how much time you get. If you got the time now, you don't know what's going to happen when you leave here. You got the time now. Glory be to God. Give God it all, because God has given his all through his son, Jesus Christ, so that we might be here. Jesus went through a whole lot for each and every one of us, so we thank God. I'm going to sing. I know we had another special surprise for you, but I'm going to preach first, and then I'm going to call someone up to give us the conclusion, and then we'll take our picture. But Ken got to get the word in with all of this mic going on. We're going to get the word in. If you will, turn with me, Matthew 28. It's on the screen if you don't have it. And 16 through the 18th verse. 16 to 18. And he reads us, then the eleven disciples went away into Galilee, into a mountain where Jesus had appointed them. And when they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. May the Lord add a blessing to his reading. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you once again for allowing us to come into your sanctuary. Thank you, Lord God, for how you blessed us and kept us throughout this time. And God, giving us the honor to praise you, to lift up our hands and to lift up our voices so that we can truly, truly, Lord God, honor you for all that you've done in our lives, for what you did and what you're still doing. So, Lord God, let the words of my mouth and meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our redeemer. Let the church say amen. 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 Amen again. You may be seated. Amen. Let's talk about the relationship and the resurrection. The relationship and the resurrection. The choir, the drama ministry, I should say, basically preached the message. They basically preached everything I was going to say, but in a glorious display, I would say, of creativity. They did a wonderful and excellent job. That if you can't get it by the word, you could get it by the acting and by the Holy Spirit working through each one of those who perform today. Not performed as in the world, but performed for Christ and giving God the glory. But we're to the point here in this capture, in this text, where we're at 11 disciples now. Yeah. As you know, one of the disciples who had betrayed Jesus is now gone and no more, to tell you the truth. Jesus develops a relationship with his disciples. That's right. And it is important, I won't say anything else today, it is important that we form a relationship with God. Because in the midst of our walk, Jesus is forming a relationship with us. He walks with us and he talks with us. He's observing us. He knows us. His understanding of us is not just based upon insight or based upon revelation, but rather Jesus' understanding of us is based upon a relationship that Jesus has with each and every one of us. After Jesus' resurrection, what goes on here is that he meets with the 11 disciples at the appointed location in Galilee. Jesus had already told them to go over to Galilee and that he will see them there. And they all come at his insistence. And most of them, when they saw him, surprised as you saw in the play, began to worship him. Well, glory be to God. Honor and glory to our God. He did just what he said he was going to do, giving God the praise and giving God the honor. That must have been the highest praise that they have ever given, because Jesus had now come back from the resurrection. From the dead, they had seen him die. They had seen him beaten. They had seen him falsely accused. But now, here he is, just like he said he would do. In other words, God keeps his promise. Whenever God tells us something, you could best believe that God is going to keep his promise. But Jesus formed a relationship with them. And when you form a relationship with somebody, you get to know them and how they will react in and out of crisis. No matter what's going on, you get to know them. Jesus knew Judas. He knew Judas not just because Judas did what he did. Jesus had formed a relationship with Judas. And he knew that Jesus was going to betray him based upon a relationship that he had with Judas. He had seen how Judas, while he walked with him, was money hungry prior to the resurrection. When Judas argued that the money for the oil that Mary poured on Jesus' feet should have been used and sold and used for the poor, he knew that something was wrong right there. And the Bible said that not that Judas cared about the poor, but because he was a thief and after the money bag for himself. So Jesus got to observe him and Jesus got to look at him. And Jesus knew also, based upon a relationship, that Peter would deny him. He knew Peter was good and he knew Peter had a little faith, but not enough faith to go all the way. That's why when he called Peter out to come with him, while Peter was on the boat, he said, come on out into the water and walk on the water. And Peter did good at first. But then all of a sudden, when the storms came, Peter began to fall in the water and Jesus had to catch him. So Jesus knew that Peter was good, but Peter was not good under pressure. He had developed that relationship with him. He had already known what he was going to do. He's good, but he's not good under pressure. So when the little girl came to him and said, weren't you with the Christ? He said, no. I mean, Peter said, no. Three times, because he was under pressure. And some people, when they're under pressure, they deny, they run away. They can't take pressure because of the consequences that comes along with it. It was based upon a relationship and observation. And he knew that the other disciples, look at Jesus, would abandon him, because when they were on the boat and Jesus was sleeping on the same boat with them, the disciples came to Jesus and said, what did they say? They said, we're going to drown. Now, if Jesus is with you, you have to have a little bit of faith to know that Jesus is not going to let you drown. Jesus is not going to let you down. But somehow they couldn't understand it. Instead of saying, Jesus, have faith in that Jesus can calm the storm. And after Jesus calmed the storm, he had to chastise them about their faith. Where is your faith, he asked. And Jesus knows our faults and our weaknesses too. Jesus knows who's going to be with him and who's not going to be with him. Because as our Savior, he's developing a relationship with us. Jesus knows what kind of crisis he can trust us in. Jesus knows who we are in terms of our crisis and how we're going to react. We know who we can call, just like us. Some of us know who we can call when we get into a crisis. And some of us know who we can't call when we get into a crisis. If you have money problems and you needed a loan for something, you know who you can call. Some friend comes to your mind, you say, you know what, I know I could call this person because I'm having some money problems. And you know who you can't call. You know who you wouldn't even think about calling. Amen. Based upon your relationship with them. If your car broke down in the middle of the night on the road, you know who you can call. You know who's going to be your friend. You know who's going to show. You know who's going to be your ride or die. That's right. That no matter what happens, that person is going to be there for you. And sometimes some people don't have anybody to call but AAA or Geico. It happens like that. When things need to be done around the church, we know who we can call or can't based upon our relationship. There are people who talk, but then there are people who work. There are people who take, and there are people who give. There are people who pray, but there are people who complain. And that's what you're going to get from them. And you know based upon a relationship who's going to do what and what times and when they're going to do it. When the crisis comes, you will be able to know that they are a worshiper or they are a doubter based upon that relationship. A worshiper has a relationship with God. A doubter is still trying to figure it out. Not that they don't. They just trying to figure it out. But there are times we must tell the truth in there. There are times no matter what's your relationship with others, that you don't have anybody to call on for your crisis but God. Yeah. There are crises that are too big for you, and they're too big for them, anybody you try to call, but they're not too hard for God. The only one you can call on is God. Jesus had no one to call on but God, but he still had to go through his heartaches and his pains. I don't want to come in and tell anybody and make you pay a dollar for a dream and make you think that just because you call on God that you won't have crisis. I come here to tell you this morning, you can call on God and still have a crisis in your life, and you will have to go through the crisis that is just for you. The only difference is that God will never leave you nor forsake you, whatever crisis you are going through, but you will still have to go through it. Some people get disappointed with God because they say, I called on my Lord, yet he did not answer. I prayed all night long, and he never changed things. Nobody said some crisis, some trouble, some things are set out just for you for the purpose that God has for you. I don't want you to get fixated that if you call on God that you won't have to go through anything, that you won't have to endure some pain. The whole idea of the cross is suffering. The purpose of the cross is that Jesus had to suffer, and you have to pick up your cross and you will have to walk with it. You have to deny yourself. You have to be willing to lose your life to gain it, because that's what God did for each and every one of us. The only difference is that God will be with us. That's why Jesus was able to speak to God while he was on the cross. Because God was with him through the whole thing. God was right there with him. Father, he yelled out to him, Father, while he was being beaten, pierced in his side. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. When the weight got too heavy, he yelled out, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? But God was right there with him. When he was ready to die, he said to the Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit. Why? Because God was right there with him. And just like God is right there with Jesus, Jesus is right there with each and every one of us when we cry out. He will go with us through the crisis that we are facing. Jesus was put into a position where no one could save him but God. And if you're going through something right, real hard right now, and you don't know how you're going to get out of it, sometimes God puts you in a position that no one can take you out of it but God, where you will have to call on the name of the Lord over and over again. God will remove people out of your way so that you can rely only on the Savior. You can't go running to this one and that one. You can't do anything because God put you in a position just like Jesus, and the only one you can call on is God. Let me get just a little political. That's why when I hear a former president comparing himself to Jesus, of being treated unfairly by the media and courts and politicians, I say nonsense. Because when you have lawyers that are paid millions to fight and delay your cases, and you have friends in high places that are raising big money for your campaign and legal fees, when you have followers that are willing to vote and fight for you no matter the ridiculousness that comes out of your mouth, the lies you tell, the false promises you make, the hell you raise, there is no way in the world you can compare yourself to Jesus. Jesus didn't have lawyers. That were for him. He had teachers of the law that were against him. He didn't have people with fat pockets to pay his bills. He had poor people who had no pockets and couldn't pay their own bills. He didn't have Bibles for sale and sneakers for sale to scam people out of their money. That sounds like more of Judas than of Jesus. If you have a relationship with Jesus, you will have to go through something. And no matter your money, no matter the politics, no matter the justice is on your side, you won't be able to call on them. They aren't able to call. Jesus, no. Your money can't save you. There are crises in life where your money can't save you. You could be the richest person in the world and still suffer from a terminal disease. Your money cannot save you. Your medicine can't save you. Your vaccination and the many boosters can't save you. Your government can't save you. We're going to get back to the place and a time where nothing else can save you but Jesus the Christ. And Jesus doesn't have to go through anybody. Jesus doesn't have to go through anything. Jesus doesn't have to go through any vaccine. Jesus does not have to go through any churches. Jesus does not have to go through any medication. Jesus does not have to go through any people. It will only be Jesus himself that will save us from our sins. Only Jesus. Only when you call on the name of Jesus, he can raise us up all by himself. Jesus got warm, and this is the party come today, met Jesus right there in Galilee, surprised and worshiping him. He surprised them with his presence right there on the mountaintop, where they all gathered together on the mountain. They had to climb up to the mountain in order to meet Jesus where he was. Not only did he raise up, but they had to go to a mountain that was raised up, that was rose up, that was up high, and they met him up on high, which signified that the land even was praising the Lord. The mountain was praising God because he had already risen. So he said, meet me on the mountaintop. And they met him on the mountaintop, and he let him know that no grave can hold my body down. No matter what you are going through, come by here to tell you, I don't care how hard it is, he got up with all power in his hand. No grave, no Pharisee, no Sadducee, no teachers of the law, nothing can hold that body down. Some worship. I know I got some worshipers. We're the worshipers. We are the worshipers. We are the worshipers. I know I got some doubters, but I come here to tell you, worshipers, raise your voice in order to let the doubters know that ain't no way in the world you can stop my Savior. Worshipers, raise your voice. Worshipers, raise your voice. He got up. He got up. He got up. And if he got up, I can get up.
No matter the sickness, you can get up. No matter the unemployment, you can get up. No matter what anybody say, you can get up. No matter who puts you down, you can get up. No matter the lies, you can get up. And when I get up, I'm not only getting up, I'm getting up with the power of the Lord all over me. Power, power. He got up. He got up. I feel good to know because he got up. And I am a worshiper. I'm not a doubter. I'm a worshiper. I come in here worshiping. I don't only worship in the church. When I leave out of here, I'm a worship. When I go to work, I'm a worship. When I go to the grocery store, I'm a worship. When I'm in the barber shop, I'm a worship. Before I lay down at night, I'm a worship. Do I have any worshipers in the house? They worship. Jesus let him know. Oh, power. Look at the God we worship. They started worshiping God even before they knew this. There's some things about God you could just feel. He said, all power. Not some power. He said, all power in heaven. That's the power with the angels. Power of the skies and the universe. All power is given unto me. He said, the power. And then he said, on earth is everybody, no matter what the scientists say, God has power over them. No matter what the government say, God has power over them. No matter what your husband or wife say, God has power over them. No matter what your children say, God has power over them. No matter what the people say, God has power over them. In other words, God can take a situation and turn it around and place your feet on solid ground. God can take a situation and turn it in your favor. What others meant for evil, God will turn into good. Oh, power! Not just some power. Not just some. No, that wouldn't be a God that I serve. I want a God that has all power. I want a God that could tell people to sit down and close up their mouth and they sit down and their mouths are shut. I want a God that can turn your enemies into your friends. I want a God that can turn your enemies against each other. I want a God that knows how to make the sun rise and the grass grow and the warm weather warm and the cold weather cold. I want that kind of God because that's the whole power. All power. All power. That's the kind of God I serve. An all-powerful God. If anybody asks you, what kind of God you serve, you be sure to say an all-powerful God. But if you don't say anything else, let them know, I serve a God that has the whole world in his hand. My God woke me up this morning. My God started me on my way. My God put food on the table. My God put fish on my plate. My God put sneakers on my feet. My God put a jacket on my back. My God gave me a haircut. My God put black on my skin. I serve a mighty God. He did it all. He did it all. He did it all. All power. All power. All power. An all-powerful God. That's the God I serve. Do I have any worshipers that can testify? Any worshipers that say yes, the kind of God I love? I love my God. I love my God, not only because he laid down his life, but he also got up with all power in his hand. That's the kind of God I love. When you have a God that you have formed a relationship with, and a God that shows you, when you have a relationship, you could worship God. You know that God is true to his word. You know that any doubt will have to leave, because doubt can't come up against your faith. When you have faith in God, things begin to happen. When things begin to happen, you begin to trust God even more. When you trust God even more, things begin to happen even more. When you know that you're ready to put your hands in God's hand, and no matter what happens, you're not going to let go of God's hand. You want to keep on going and rolling with the Lord and Savior, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the one who is everything in every life throughout all generations. You want to hold to God's unchanging hand. So when we come in here, we come in here. If you don't think of anything else, think about the goodness of Jesus. Think about the goodness of Jesus. That right there will prompt you to worship. That will take away any doubts. That will let you know any crisis that you are going through, that there's nothing too hard for God. That God is able. That you will get through it. You may have to fall, but God will pick you back up. You may get sad sometime, but the joy of the Lord is your strength. You may lose friends, but where two or three Holy Spirit is gathered, you are never, ever alone. Our God is able. Does anybody here have a relationship with God? Do you have a relationship with God? Does God know your name? Does Jesus know your name? Is your name? And we'll find out. Because I love the Bible. That's one book. I love reading all kinds of stuff. There are books out there. But there's one book I want to make sure that I get in. There's a book that the government does not have, no matter how many CIA spies they have. There's a book that Trump can't write in and turn around and make it his own. There's a book that not many people have authored and not many people can subscribe to. The book that I'm talking about is the book of life. And only when you get to heaven does God look down the book of life and see if your name is in that book. And if your name is in the book, then you're going on into the kingdom. If your name is not in the book, then you're going on somewhere else. I don't know about you, but I'm working hard to make sure that my name is in the book. I want to see the Lamb. I want to see my Savior. I want to see the one who died for me. I want to see the one who's at the right hand of the Father. I want to rise up and I want to go on the way to my Father's house.
That's right.
To my Father's house.
Yeah.
Is there anybody here? If you don't have a relationship, that relationship becomes very, very important. Uh-huh. It becomes important because not only do you get to know Jesus, but Jesus gets to know you.
Well.
That's the whole point of Jesus gets to know us. He knows us. And the reason why Jesus gets to know us is so that he knows where to strengthen us.
Uh-huh.
I'll talk more about that next week, but he'll know where to strengthen us. You can see how he strengthened Peter because he got to know him. So if you had any weaknesses, if you have any flaws, if you have any sins, which we all fall short of the glory of God, the truth of the matter, Jesus is not getting to know us so that he can condemn us. Jesus is getting to know us so that he can resurrect us. That's his purpose for getting to know us. So no matter who you are, Jesus said, you got this problem, just like Peter, just like Judas, but I'm going to help you with your situation.
Well,
Judas couldn't be helped. I'm going to help you with your situation. So God is saying, if you're here right now, Think about your relationship. Think about your relationship. And if you feel like you need a better relationship, you feel like you need to grow in a church home, or you need to just come to Jesus, this is your opportunity. I'm not talking about come to church. There's a lot of church folks that still need help. I'm talking about come to Jesus first, and then Jesus will work out the church. If you're here right now, let us stand. Let us stand.
Come,
the church doors
to
Jesus.
Are open. Come to Jesus. Just now.
Yes,
just now. Come to Jesus. Oh, come.
Yes, yes, Lord.
Oh, he will save you.
Yes, he will. If you just come to Jesus, you want to join the fellowship of the church, that's great too.
He will save you.
He will save you. We have testimonies. We have witnesses.
Just now. Only trust him. Only trust him. Only trust
him.
Just now. Only trust him.
Only trust.
Just now.
Are you sure? Are you sure? If you're sure, then you can sit down. You can sit down if you're sure you have a relationship. You can sit down there. If not, the church doors are open. The church doors are open.
Oh, he will.
I'm going to call our sister. Come on. She's ready. She's going to play.
He will. Oh, he will. Come to Jesus just now.
Yeah. Just now. We thank God. Our young sister, we'll wait until another Sunday. We will move the service along. We thank all of you for coming out, and thank God. Give yourselves a big hand, amen. Give yourselves a big hand. Thank the Lord, God, for being in his house this morning. We thank all of you we haven't seen in a long time. Where's Sister Vanessa? God bless you. Amen. Oh, you haven't been here in a long time. Amen. I'm always glad to see you. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. Who else? Who else? Oh, I see it. Go ahead, Sister Carrie. Go ahead. That's your daughter. You make sure. And son-in-law, amen. Your whole family, amen. Amen. Stand up, y'all. Stand up. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Amen. Hey, long time. Long time. Amen. God bless you. Any other family members here that we haven't seen in a long time? Amen. Hey, how you doing? I can't. Amen. God bless you. Good to have you. Good to have you. Bless your heart. Amen. Who's that? That's right. Amen. Oh, okay. God bless you. Amen. That's why you're dancing all over the place. Uh-huh. Who's that? Who's that? Your aunt? Oh, okay. Oh, okay. I'd rather say she's your aunt, but you her aunt. Yeah, right. Just right. Well, it's good to have you. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. Any others? Any others? God bless you. Well, we all family in the house of the Lord. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. Your what? Your oldest daughter? Okay, bless you. Good to have you in the house. Amen.
Amen. I want to make sure. Don't do that, Peggy. Our sister Joyce, Mary Brown is in the house. God bless you. Stand up, Sister Brown. Go ahead. I know you're going to mess. I'm going to mess with you. I just wanted to see you. God bless you. Peggy, it's good to see you there. Amen. Good to see all of you. I see you. You're hiding behind our sister Marcia. I know. I see her. I see her. Amen. That's right, the whole crew. Stand up there. Stand up. Sister, yeah, that's right, you. You. And that whole crew back there. Amen. Yeah. That old crew back there. God bless you all. No, I was talking about a former trustee right here. That's what I was talking about. Gloria, that's it. That's it. Talking about you. Amen. It's good to see you. Who? Pat and Bria. Oh my God. Bria. How you doing? God bless you. Amen. You're grown up now. Amen. She used to always bring me the candies when she was younger. Amen. John said, here, Pastor, right after service, she bring me that piece of candy. I didn't know she was saying you need a mint after all of that, but it was good to know. Amen. God bless you. Good to have you all in the house this morning. Amen. Amen. I'm going to make sure for somebody to say, you forgot me. You forgot me. Not on resurrection. Not on resurrection Sunday. I'm not going to forget you on resurrection Sunday. Amen. Amen. God bless you all. Amen. We good to go? Or y'all want to stay another hour? Well, he's like, oh, I ain't even been to church that long. I ain't even trying to stay in here. Let us all stand. Amen. Amen. Yeah. And don't worry. We get it the next time, all right? We good. Don't worry about it. God bless you. Can I just say, our sister, she's a great pianist. I don't want to shine too much of that, but she's a great young age, and she's such a great pianist. Just wave your hand at least. Just great. She's on her way. I always like, I called her. I'm the one. It's my fault. I just popped it on her, and I said she plays so well, and that's the granddaughter of our deacon Campbell. But she plays so well. I'm always delighted to hear her. We'll have another opportunity. So I'm glad she wasn't quite ready, so you're going to have to come back. You're going to have to come back. And I'm telling you, when she plays, you will feel the Spirit of the Lord all over you, because she's a great, God has just blessed her parents and her sister. All of them are here. So I'm just going to make sure that we get that done. But we thank God for you. I know we're going to, those who will take the picture, if you're not, you can exit, you can go out the door. Those who will take the congregational picture, just please stand in the front, and Tim is ready to take the picture, so we'll take it right after service, okay? All right. Dean Reed, are we ready to go? We good? Okay. Lord God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord God, for a wonderful day. We thank you, Lord God, for a blessed day. We thank you, Lord God, for a resurrection Sunday. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. And we ask in Heavenly Father that you would continue to go with us as we grow with you. Help us, Lord God, to develop a better relationship with you. Even if we have one, we want to develop a better relationship. We want to be able to talk holy and walk holy. We want to be able, Lord God, to do not our will, but thy will be done. We want to be able to raise up and rise up at that appointed time and find ourselves in your arms, in your kingdom, in your mansion. So, Lord God, help us to walk the walk that we need to walk right here. Lord God, we know that you're not finished with us yet. There's more work to be done. And, Lord God, we put our lives in your hand so that you can mold us and make us, Lord God, into what you will. Help us, Lord God, to be loving towards one another. Help us, Lord God, to uplift one another. Since we've been uplifted, we ought to know how to uplift one another. Each and every brother and sister in the house this morning, we want to uplift each other Every child, Lord God, uplift them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord God, for the congregational togetherness. Thank you for the drama ministry. Thank you, Lord God, for the choir. Thank you, Lord God, for the recording. Thank you for the nurses. Thank you for the ushers. Thank you for the diaconate. Thank you, Lord God, for the fellowship of every member and friend that came. Thank you for the music ministry, Lord God. All that you have gathered us here in order to raise the praise for you. And we ask, Lord God, that we go out of here still worshiping. Let us not take your name off of our tongues. But let us, Lord God, continue to talk about you to everybody we know so that, Lord God, you can get the glory. You can get the honor. We thank you, Lord God, as we go out of here praising your holy name. In the name of Jesus we pray. Let the church say, oh, my God.
We don't have to put no blood on the door. Someone has taken the place of the Lamb. Is Jesus the great I am? We don't have to slay the lamb anymore.